My name is Parvathi Nayar. I am a visual artist based in Chennai. The core of my practice is drawing, graphite on wood, but I also do video and animation and artist books, bookmaking, photography. So a variety of practices with a central core practice in drawing. I also write. Practically all my life, I've both drawn and written, and I've written about the arts and written, I write poetry. And so very recently, the two sort of started coming together, as in the idea of doing artist books, which in this particular case used some of my poetry, but was a good coming together of different fields of creativity for me. I guess my art is about trying to make the viewer see the world he or she knows well a little differently. So it sort of straddles that line very often between abstraction and reality. In other words, when you're looking at something, you think you're looking at an abstract image, but it's not. It's reality seen through a different filter, whether it's science via extreme levels of magnification with a scanning tunneling electron microscope, or something seen through a telescope, you know, images that are given to us by cutting-edge technology, which I then mediate, fragment, appropriate, and represent to the viewer in different ways. They certainly don't need to see it the way I see it, but they need to see something that makes them engage with the work of art and take away something that will make them stay with that image or series of images or ideas or thoughts, and hopefully alter perceptions a little bit. You know, art today is about creating some kind of rupture, some kind of intervention into lives, which need not be sort of big. It need not be agitprop art. It need not be activist art. In fact, my art is none of those things. But to create that moment where you pause, you consider, you reflect, you rethink something you were thinking about. I think that's what I'd like my art to do. Maybe it comes out of a desire in me to question these ideas and identities of who am I, what am I. You know, big questions which, you know, you're constantly seeking different frames with which to ask these questions of, you know, what am I doing here? What's my place in the universe? What indeed is the universe made of? And in a way, I use science as a prism with which to reappropriate some of these questions and bring them back into an artistic cultural sphere. So, yes, I do care that this dialogue that I'm initiating is completed by the person looking at the work of art. But at the same time, the work of art is not a mass appeal thing. It might engage with you, you might choose to complete the dialogue, or you might say, doesn't move me, and that's perfect. You can walk away. I find the most fulfilling is when I'm able to present the work as a solo, or in a space that I can control in some way. So that the experience of the drawings, the experience of the work of art, whether it's drawings or drawings and text, or drawings and text and sound, or drawings and text and sound and photographs and animation, all of this is through a journey, so through interconnected spaces. So, you know, while I don't direct, I propose ways of going through the space that I control to some extent, and I therefore feel I'm able to give a more experiential feeling of the art. You know, shows like the solos that I've done, such as I Sing the Body Electric, or Win, Lose, Draw, or the very recent solo that I did, The Ambiguity of Landscapes, where works like this, where the whole show is the artwork, where the entire space, where the entire aspect of the viewer moving through the space is what completes the show. And I would find those the most exciting and challenging. What drives the creation and then how it is created, both aspects are important to me. Science is something I've always enjoyed, but I get it through through words. So it's not that I'm looking at a mathematical equation and I'm saying, I understand it, I get how clever and how elegantly that mathematical equation is. I don't get that. But when somebody talks about a mathematical equation and says, that is an elegant resolution of this problem, I get it. And I think that's really neat. And to then harness that way of describing the world, that way of describing an event, that way of describing phenomena, and using that in a quasi-scientific sense in the art is something that I enjoy and something that I feel is, that is my worldview projected. So there is technology, then it's being brought back into, you know, the oldest art form in the world. It's being drawn, it's being mediated with a hand-done process of realizing these ideas. And when I'm presenting it to you, I'm telling you to think about them. You know, I use water a lot, you know, in the work, because at some aesthetic level, I like its ability to sort of straddle the abstract and the real, because it's sort of so fluid, it takes on any shape, it moves, it's got no shape, it has a shape. Its fluidity, its transmutability, its multiple identities. Maybe I resonate with that, and maybe I resonate with how much sort of water is, you know, a carrier of information sometimes in many ways. So, you know, here in Kochi, when I look at, you know, the waves from the Arabian Sea dashing against the coast of India, to me that has a certain resonance or a reference to the traders who came and hit the shores of India, and there was a collision. I mean, any kind of coming together of different cultures, different bodies of knowledge, different people is in some ways a big or a small collision. And from these collisions, knowledge is created, histories are changed, people are changed. So conceptually, the whole idea of the trader and the traveler going, coming, looking, searching, changing is very much part of the small journey that I am doing in Kochi, in, you know, as part of this Biennale, because my roots lie here, and it's in some ways it will impact on the work, whether it's obviously or subtly. Yeah, I know this sounds sort of very sort of egoistical or simplistic or childish, but when I first read Jitesh's note, I thought he'd written it for me. It was so perfect, really. There was also a tremendous resonance with Jitesh's curatorial note about, you know, travelers, journeys, trade, which are many of the things that I deal with in different ways in the work. And at the same time, while this journey of people and places is happening in our world, there is this other celestial journey that constantly appears in my work, of Earth hurtling through space, of being part of this vast cosmos, and of being sort of unaware of this journey. So, you know, it was a wonderful resonance for me reading Jitesh's curatorial note. You explore, things open up, you put that onto your work, the work will change the space will change the work. And this process is very important to whatever the work ultimately created is. This process, I think, is critical to it.